Updating some late breaking news, a family responds after a murder-suicide.
Police say Amber Wright's ex-boyfriend gunned her down at their Midwest City apartment complex. He then turned the gun on himself. The two leave behind a one-year-old daughter. Eyewitness News 5's Jessica Holloway is live. Jessica, police say this tragedy could have been prevented.
You know, Paul, it all happened right near this loading dock behind Crest Foods. That's where Patrick Ball worked, and everyone we spoke to says they never expected something like this to happen.
911, is this a medical emergency?
It might be. There's gunfire and screaming.
Witnesses call 911 for help.
Do you know how many shots you heard?
About 8, at least, and a woman screaming her head off.
Okay.
And breaking glass.
Police say Patrick Ball chased Amber Wright before shooting and killing her, then turning the gun on himself.
Yeah, we heard breaking glass, then we heard a woman screaming and yelling, and then we all of a sudden just heard just bang, 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 bang.
Okay.
The two had a baby together, but a judge granted a restraining order against Ball. He violated that twice and recently sent her threatening text messages.
In this case, it appears that Ms. Wright did everything right. She filed for the victim protection orders. They were granted. She contacted the police department when there was a violation.
Police recommended charges and an arrest warrant issued with the wrong name, something the police chief discovered after Amber's murder yesterday. All of the records in his office had the correct spelling. He says in domestic cases, police can only work within the parameters of the law.
This is if you're in the abusive relationship, you need to get out, because if you don't, it could result in something like happened yesterday.
Yesterday, when a young mother was taken too soon.
It was a male. He came outside the apartment with a gun, and he fired off like 6 or 7, maybe 8 rounds at this girl, and there's someone laying outside on the ground. Oh, my God.
The baby is now with relatives. Amber's family shared these words with us. They say this was an all-around tragedy. Amber was independent, strong-willed, and a good mother. And we have no idea why this happened. We never saw it coming. Reporting live, Jessica Holloway, Eyewitness News 5.
Okay, Jessica, the YWCA is asking everyone to wear black ribbons in honor of Amber. That way they can bring attention to the domestic abuse problem in Oklahoma.